concepts of their therapeutic or drug monitoring. Concepts of therapeutic drug monitoring. Therapeutic drug monitoring is based on the principle that for some drugs, there is a close relationship between the plasma level of drug and its clinical effects. If such a relationship does not exist, therapeutic drug monitoring is of little value. The clinical value of plasma level monitoring depends on how precisely the treatment's outcomes and defined. When a precise therapeutic endpoint is difficult to define, monitoring of drug levels may be considerable therapeutic assistant. Therapeutic range, therapeutic window. The therapeutic range, therapeutic window is the concentration range. Therapeutic range and therapeutic window is the concentration range of drug in plasma, where the drug has been shown to be efficacious without causing toxic effect in most people. These are the therapeutic range and therapeutic window. This is the toxic range. About serum concentration is about the 25 to 30, then toxic range, and 15 to 25 is therapeutic range, and steady state, and 0 to 15 is subtherapeutic range. Target concentration and therapeutic range. Target concentration and therapeutic range. The therapeutic range concepts suffer from the strategic deficiencies. First, the idea of a range introduces uncertainty into exactly how to prescribe the desired dose. The second deficiency is the implicate assumptions that all concentrations within the range are equally desirable. On the other hand, the target concentration is directly linked to a specific dose for an individual, not a range of dose. Selection of a target concentration requires a understanding of the concentration effect relationship. Example, pharmacodynamics for both desired and undesired effects. The target concentration is chosen to optimize the balance between these effects. These are the target concentration and therapeutic range. Steps involved in target concentration strategy. Steps involved in target concentration strategy. Select a target concentration. First one step is select a target concentration, then predict clearance, and volume of distributions values for the patient based on population, pharmacokinetic parameters, and observable individual characteristics, weight, renal functions. Then calculate the loading dose and maintenance dose ratio to achieve the target concentration. Calculate the loading dose and maintenance dose rate to achieve the target concentrations, and administer the dose and measure drug concentrations. Use the measurement concentrations to predict individualized value of clearance and volume of distributions for the patients. If appropriate, revise the target concentration for the individual based on clinical assessments. Revert to step third. These are the steps involved in the target concentration strategy. Therapeutic drug monitoring of established drugs. Therapeutic drug monitoring of established drugs. there are many types of category in therapeutic drug monitoring of established drugs. First one category is cardioactive drugs. Cardioactive drugs like amiodarone, dioxin, dizitoxin, disopyramides, lignocaine, procainamides, propranolol, and quinidines. These are the cardioactive drugs. Second one category is antibiotic. Antibiotics like gentamicin, amikacin, tobramycin, that are the antibiotics. And third one is antidepressants category. Like lithium and tricyclic antidepressants. Next one is anti-epileptic drugs like phenytoin, phenobarbital, benzodiazepines, carbamazepines, valproic acids, and ethosuximides. These drugs are under the anti-epileptic drugs. And next one category is bronchodilators. Example of bronchodilator is theophylline, caffeine. These are the bronchodilators. Next one category is cancer chemotherapy. Methotrexates, immunosuppressive agents like cyclosporine, tacrolimus. These are the drugs of established in therapeutic drug monitoring. Therapeutic drug monitoring indications. Indications of therapeutic drug monitoring. Drug for which relationship between dose and plasma concentration is unpredictable. Example, phenytoin. Phenytoin drug for which relationship between dose and plasma concentration is unpredictable. And second one is drug with a narrow therapeutic window. Will allow doses alterations to produce optimal therapeutic effects or to avoid toxic effects. Example, lithium, phenytoin, and digoxins. Third one is drugs with steps dose responsive curve. Example, theophylline. Theophylline is responsible for the steps dose responsive curve. Drugs for which there is difficulty in measuring and interpreting the clinical evidence of therapeutic or toxic effects. Example, nausea and vomiting occurs in both dizziness toxicity and congestive heart failure. Next one, drug with suitable metabolism like phenytoin, drug with poorly defined endpoint or difficult to clinically predict the response. Example, immunosuppressants drugs. Seventh one, renal disease. Renal disease alter the relationship between dose and the plasma concentration. Important in case of digoxins, lithium and aminoglycosides antibiotics. These are the renal disease. Drug interactions, when another drug alters the relationship between dose and plasma concentrations. Example, plasma concentration of lithium is increased by thiazides. Thiazides responsible for the plasma concentration increase of lithium. Drug with large individual variability. Drug is drug interactions when another drug alters the relationship between dose and plasma concentrations. Example, plasma concentration of lithium and is increased by thiazides. Drug with large individual variability at steady states, PDC in any given dose. For diagnosis of suspected toxicity and determine drug abuse. And 11 is to evaluate compliance of patients. And 12 is guideline withdrawal of therapy. Anti-epileptics, cyclosporins, these drugs are withdrawal of therapy guideline. Drugs that are not suitable for therapeutic drug monitoring. Drugs that are not suitable for therapeutic drug monitoring. First one, drug having wide therapeutic index. Drugs having wide therapeutic index, toxicity is not a realistic concern. Penicillin effects can measured using functional laboratory tests, anticoagulants, plasma concentration not predictably related to effects, anticoagulants. Fifth one, effect of the relationship remains undefined, antidepressants. Sixth one, hit and run drugs, omeprazoles, MAO inhibitors, monoamine oxidase inhibitors. These drugs are under the MAO inhibitors like selegiline, rasegiline. These are the MAO inhibitors, monoamine oxidase inhibitors. Basic principles of therapeutic drug monitoring. The following are important considerations to ensure an optimum therapeutic drug monitoring services in MECT. First one is measurement of patient serum or plasma drug concentration taken at appropriate time after drug administrations. And second one is knowledge of pharmacological and pharmacokinetic. Knowledge of pharmacological and pharmacokinetic profile of administered drugs. And third one is knowledge of relevant patients profile like dopaminergic data, clinical status, laboratory and other clinical investigations. And fourth one is interpretations of SDC after taking into considerations all of the above informations and individualizing drugs regimen according to the clinical needs of the patients. Process of therapeutic drug monitoring. Developing of plasma profile in each patient. First one, administering a predetermining dose of drug. Second one, collection of blood samples, then determination of blood samples, then plasma profile and pharmacokinetic model development and clinical effect of drugs, development of dose regimen, then dose diagnosis, dosage form selections, dosage regimen, initiation of therapy. Then last one is evaluation of clinical response. This is the process of therapeutic drug monitoring. Samples. Sample selections must include an appropriate matrix. Plasma or serum is commonly used for drug assays. Whole blood for cyclosporin, tacrolimus, sirolimus, and there are large shifts of drugs between red cells and plasma with storage and temperature changes. Saliva, which gives a measure of unbound drug concentrations, may be a useful alternative when blood samples are difficult to collect. Example, phenytoin, lithium, amitriptyline. These are the samples. Before collecting the sample, establish that SDC is at steady states. Ensure complete absorption and distributions. Ensure complete absorption and distributions. Samples should be collected and centrifuged as soon as possible. Avoid serum separate tubes because there may be lower drug concentration due to the absorption of drug into the matrix. Lower drug concentration. Avoid serum separate tubes because these may lower drug concentration due to the adsorption of drug into the matrix. And storage of samples. Plastic cryovial type tubes are acceptable for most assays for CSA. Whole blood to be collected in a EDTA tubes. Analytical methods may be affected by temperature and all variables should be standardized. Guidelines to specimen collections. Specimen collections. Guidelines to specimen collections. Drawn blood used for therapeutic drug monitorings. Demonstrates and drug actions in the body at any specific time. Therefore, blood testing is the procedure of choice when definite data are required for adequate absorption and therapeutic levels to accurate. For adequate absorption and therapeutic levels to accurate, it is important to allow for sufficient time to pass between the administrations of the medications for adequate absorption and therapeutic level to be accurate. It is important to allow for sufficient time to pass between the administration of the medications and the collection of the blood sample. Blood specimen for drug monitoring can be taken at two different times, during the drug highest therapeutic concentration peak level or its lowest trough level. Occasionally called residual level, trough levels show sufficient therapeutic levels where peak levels show toxicity. The peak levels show toxicity. Peak and trough levels should fall within the therapeutic range. Peak and trough level should fall within the therapeutic range. Patient receiving a drug at a dosing interval. Patients receiving a drug at a dosing interval longer than the half-life of the drug will demonstrate large fluctuation between peak and trough level. Plasma concentration of drug dosed at intervals shorter than their half-life would show less fluctuations between peak and trough levels. For chronically administered oral medications, the peak levels usually occurs 1 to 2 hours after the dose and trough serum concentration shortly after the dose and administered. Toxin is one exception. Digoxin is one exception. The serum level to determine peak activity should be drawn after the serum digoxins had time of equilibrates with these tissues 6 to 10 hours after the oral dose. Drawing the trough level at the time the dose is given is usually sufficiently accurate. Intravenous medications should also be given time to equilibrate before the peak level is drawn. There should be samples open 1 hour after administrations. For example, the peak serum level of gentamicin should be drawn 30 minutes after infusion of drugs and then not immediately after the infusions. Intramuscularly administered medications, if injected in an area with good blood flow, with achieve peak level within a similar time frame and intravenous. Medications that are poorly soluble at body pH. However, MAP precipitates at the site of injections and achieve very low and lead peak serum levels. The clinician should know what questions are to be answered by these samples. Being drawn in different questions may require different sampling time and possibly different numbers of samples. For example, the questions of toxicity. For example, the questions of toxicity may be answered by only one-state samples, where determinations of half-life will require at least two samples drawn at a more precise times after the drug and administered. For patients suspected of symptoms of drug toxicity, the best time to draw to blood specimen and when the symptoms are occurring, example, immediately at the time of presentations. Timing of sample collections. The best sample timing is the pre-dose or trough phase when a drug is administered by multiple oral dose. Trough concentration are commonly used for many drugs. Peak concentration may be useful, some antibiotics, aminoglycosides, and correct sample timing should also taken into account absorption and distribution. Example, digoxin sample are collected after 6 hours of administrations. Timing of sample collections. For short half-life drugs, more than one sample, three is ideal. Is the most useful for determining individual pharmacokinetic parameters. Alternatively, a peak Cmax and trough Cmin can be collected to determine the bound of high and low concentrations and at steady states. For long half-life drugs, digoxin, phenobarbital, a single sample during the dosing interval is sufficient. If one suspects altered clearance rates, more samples can be collected to assess half-life. For cyclosporine, a single throw sample has been used for many years, but now recommendations are changing to a single to half samples you do. For cyclosporine, a throw usually referred to a 12-hour samples. Even though this drug is used once a day or once even other days, some patients. Sample timing for some important drugs. First one drug is phenytoin. Since phenytoin has a long half-life, a single daily dose may be employed, and so the timing of concentration monitoring is not critical. And carbamazepines, its half-life may be as long as 48 hours following a single dose. A trough concentration taking just after a dose together with a peak level 3 hours later is ideal. Digoxin, the measurement must be made at least 6 hours after a dose to avoid inappropriate high levels. Option D, theophylline. These drugs have a narrow therapeutic index and timing of sampling is not critical. If the patient is receiving one of these low release formulations wherein throw level should be taken. Lithium. A 12-hour sample given the most. A 12-hour sample gives the most precise guide to dosage adjustments. Next one, gentamicin. Pre-dose peaks 0.5 hours after IV and 1 hour after IM administrations. Sample concentrations. sample concentrations, lower than anticipateds, higher than anticipateds, lower than anticipateds. First one, patient's non-compliance, patient non-compliance, error in dose determined, rapid eliminations, timing of sample, changing hepatic blood flow, poor bioavailability, reduced plasma bindings, and higher than anticipateds, error in dosing regimens, rapid bioavailability, slow eliminations, increased plasma concentration binding, decreased renal hepatic functions. These are the difference between lower than anticipateds and higher than anticipateds. Interpretive criteria, therapeutic range. These are the recommendations derived by observing the clinical response of a small group of patients taking the drug. The lower limit is set to provide 50% of the maximum therapeutic effects, while the upper limit is defined by toxicity. Therapeutic ranges are not absolutes, and hence experts' clinical interpretations of the obtained value is necessary to derive measuring from the results. Data on duration of drug therapy, dose and timing of the last dose is important. In the duration of therapy, dose and time of the last dose is important. Pure therapeutic drug monitoring testing takes into consideration all the factors that can affect results in interpretations. These are the interpretive criteria. Factors that affect results of therapeutic drug monitoring, like pharmacokinetics affect the absorption, distributions, metabolism, and excretions. Second one is pharmacodynamic. Pharmacodynamic affect the mechanism of actions. And next one is dose, sampling time and type, testing methodology, genetic polymorphism. These are the factors that affect the results. Genetic polymorphism, other variables, smoking, drug information for informing drug formulations, and circadian effects with of alternative systems of medicines like Sung Fuspi and Vias Phenytoins. Interactions with conventional drugs have been documented for leucorrhiz, ginsengs, tannic acids, plantains, azorra roots, hawthorns, and cowsins. These are the factors that affect the results. Major source of pharmacokinetic variability, like patient's compliance, patient compliance lack of, as neonates, children, elderly, physiology, genders, pregnancy, and disease, hepatic, renal, cardiovascular, respiratory, drug-to-drug interactions, and environmental influence. These are the major sources of pharmacokinetic variability. Therapeutic drug monitoring of cyclosporine. Monitoring should take into account First one is the blood level of cyclosporine. The blood level of cyclosporine and the therapeutic interval different for renal, liver, and heart transplantations. And the correlation that exists between therapeutic interval and acute graft rejections and nephrotoxicity. Frequency of cyclosporine. Frequency of cyclosporine blood level determination should be at 2 to 3 days in the first 4 weeks post transplants, then monthly after 3 months. Because cyclosporine binds significantly to red blood cells. All bloods is the better biological matrix for assigning cyclosporine concentration than plasma. The therapeutic, these are the therapeutic drug monitoring of cyclosporine. The purpose of monitoring is the prevent rejection of improved tolerance, avoidance of nephrotoxicity and to high immunosuppression. C-trots residual concentrations, C0 pre-dose concentration is directly correlated with nephrotoxicity, but it is not a useful marker for predictions of acute rejections. Instead, both nephrotoxicity and acute rejections are better correlated with the area under the concentrations time curve measured between 0 to 4 hours or 0 to 12 hours. Area under curve Z4 and 0 to 4 and area under curve 0 to 12. This value can be better estimated using the value of C2 blood levels 2 hours post dose. Then the residual concentrations, greater variability occurs in the absorption phase in the initial 4 to 6 hours after the CS dose. C2 concentration can be used as a surrogate index of CSA absorption and exposures. Number of crates 1, 2, 3, transplantation type, renal transplantations, hepatic transplantations, cardiac transplantations, targeted values, whole bloods in C0, 200 to 400 and 125 to 275, 100 to 125 and observation 200 to 400 and 1.4 to 2. 15 days post transplantations and 125 to 275 and C2 1.2 to 1.8, 2 to 3 post transplantation good renal functions and 2 to 3 months post transplantation poor renal functions and 100 to 150, 0.7 to 1, 6 months later and post transplantation. These are the renal transplantation type and hepatic 250 to 350 and 100 to 200, 0.8 to 1.2 and 0.6 to 1.6 first 6 months and 6 months to 1 year post transplantations. Cardiac in which targeted values 250 to 350 initially and 100 to 200, 6 months to 1 year post transplantations. Therapeutic drug monitoring. Aminoglycosides needs for monitorings, bactericidal activity links to peak concentrations, desired profile high peaks, and toxicity like ototoxicity, nephrotoxicity related to total drugs exposures, desired profiles, no throats, no accumulations, and traditional monitorings, peak and trough concentrations. Targets for IV gentamicins. Targets for IV gentamicins peak 30 to 60 minutes post dose and 5 to 10 microgram per liter throw before next dose and less than 2 mg per liter. Therapeutic drug monitoring of phenytoin. Therapeutic range 10 to 20 microgram per ml time to study takes 7 to 10 days. Needs for monitoring because of narrow therapeutic window, high protein bound drug-drug interactions, drug-disease interactions, non-linear pharmacokinetics even within the therapeutic range, inter-individual variability in enzyme saturations. Approximately 90% of phenytoin is bound to albumin. Albumin is a protein. Thus, phenytoin level must be corrected according to albumin level. Corrected phenytoin mg per level. Observed phenytoin in mg per liter per O2 into albumin gram per dl plus 0.1. Phenytoin level are generally monitored at 3 to 12 months intervals. Therapeutic drug monitoring of digoxin. Therapeutic range of digoxin is 1 to 2 mg per liter taken more than 6 hours post-dosing, and 1 nanogram per liter is 1.3 nanomole per liter. For inotropic effects, not air. Steady state of digoxin is 3 to 5 half-lives and equal to 5 to 7 days normal T-half and 1 to 3 weeks result renal dysfunctions. Toxicity may be non-specific. Example, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, confusion, bradycardia, heavy junctional gaps, rhythms, and visual disturbance. PK problems. 10% population have enteric bacterium. 10% population have enteric bacterium, E-lac, lanthums, that can metabolize digoxins, large volume of disturbance, 5 liter per kg with lean body weight, and predominantly excreted, unchanged in the urine with CL and GFR, proportional to GFR. Large number of interactions. Therapeutic drug monitoring of theophylline. Therapeutic range 5 to 20 mg per ml. Time to steady state 36 hours average. Toxicity manifest as tachyarrhythmias, vomiting, and convulsions. PK problems, bioavailability varies widely between preparations, 90% elimination by the liver and 10% unchanged in the urine, reserve into ratio in neonates. No adjustments for renal failure required, but dose in presence of impaired hepatocellular functions. Whenever possible, establish drug level before administering IV, and if in doubt, do not establish drug before admission IV. Do not give bolus loading dose. Drawing levels, first oral solution in immediate release tablets 1 to 2 hours after administration. Extended release tablets 4 to 12 hours after administrations. Injections 30 minutes after completion of intravenous loading dose. A second measurement should be obtained after one expected half-life. 4 hours in children's age and 1 to 9 years and 8 hours in non-smoking adults. Techniques for measurements of therapeutic drug monitoring. HPLC, high pressure liquid chromatography. The separation of a substance depends on the relative distributions of mixture constituents between two phases, a mobile phase carrying the mixture and a stationary phase. Liquid chromatography, mass chromatography, liquid chromatography and mass spectrophotometry. All chromatography based techniques work on the principle that different substances are absorbed differently in solutions. Two phases of materials are used in separate the components of a solution. The mobile phase carries the sample along the stationary or solid phase. This separates out the components in the sample. Gas chromatography and mass spectrophotometry is a separation method. Gas chromatography is a separation method using very high temperatures to cause samples evaporations. In mass spectrometry, the vaporized functions are passed through electrical fields. the molecules can be separates on the basis of molecular weights. The pattern of separates is unique to each drugs and therefore establish and fingerprints for identification. Gas chromatography, mass spectrometry is the world standards methods for the identification of drugs of abuse. EIA, enzyme immunoassay. Enzyme immunoassay use and non-radioactive enzymes labels. Most of drug testing today is performed using homogeneous enzymes immunoassay techniques. These refer to the facts that the assay are performed in the single steps. Only one antibody is used in the procedure. Therefore, the turnaround times for testing is reduced. Radioactive assay. Use radioactivity to detect the presence of analyte. Use radioactivity to detect the presence of analytes. In radio immunoassay, this sample is incubated with the antibody and radio labeled drugs. The amount of radioactivity measures in compared to the radioactive presence in the non-standards which are induced included in the each runs. Results are quantitative. Patinia, an immune target matrix methods, particle enhanced activity matrix inhibition immunoassay. This method used to correction of creation of light scattering particles to measure drug levels. EMIT. EMIT means enzyme multiplied immunoassay techniques based on competition for the target analyte antibody binding sites. FPIA, fluorescence polarization immunoassay. This method uses fluorescent molecules as the label initiator of enzymes, making it more sensitive. Chemical immunoassay. This is a chemical reaction that emits energy in the form of lights. When used in combinations with immunoassay technology, with the light produced by the reactions, indicates the amounts of analytes in the samples. The most common combination assay methods are either enzymes amplified or direct chemiluminescence measurements. ACMI, affinity chrome mediated immunoassay, is a technique to measure drug concentration in which free and drug bound antibodies enzyme conjugates are separates using magnetic chrome particles. CEDI, cloned enzyme donor immunoassay, employed as a recombinant DNA technology. Clinical significance of therapeutic drug monitoring, maximum efficacy, avoid toxicity, identifies therapeutic failure, no compliance, subtherapeutic dose, facilitates the adjustment of dose, new dose, old dose, into desired C and old dose, facilitates the therapeutic effects of drug by achieving target drug concentrations, identifying poisoning, drug toxicity, and drug abuse. Request form for therapeutic drug monitoring. But practical issue in the therapeutic drug monitoring. Ideally, a quality drug assay should be performed within a time frame that is clinically useful. Once the decisions to monitor the concentration of a therapeutic drug has been made, it's important that a biological sample is collected to provide a clinically meaningful measurements. An appropriate pharmacokinetic evaluations required the acquisition of properly timed blood specimens. Absorption is variable after oral administrations, and blood samples should be collected in the elimination phase rather than in the absorption is distribution phase. Pre-drugs monitoring, develop a new filtration device equipment, dialysis, ultrafiltrations, ultracentrifugations has made it is possible to measure free unbound drug levels in the serum. The advantages are that the free concentration is independent of change in plasma bindings and is the pharmacologically active concentration. The disadvantages are that is time consuming, expensive, and therapeutic range do not yet exist for many drugs. Drug concentration, other fluids of body be measured during benzodiazepines, sweets, cocaine and heroin, saliva, marijuana and cocaine alcohols, birds, alcohols, use of saliva in drug monitoring, high concentration of a drug in saliva is proportional in the concentration of and bound in the plasma. The practice of measuring drugs in saliva clinics in the non-insensitive overrates the limitations. Cost effectiveness. The measurement of drug levels in the body fluids may be cost effective. The cost of performing individual tests is determined by the summoning equipment, personal supplies, and overhead expenditures for a given period of time, and dividing the amount by the number of assays performed in the same time intervals. These are the references of therapeutic drug monitorings. MCQs is a naturally occurring element that was accidentally performed to sterilize wounds. Option A is serotonin. Option B is dyskinesia. Option C is disability. The right answer is C, lithium. Are a group of drugs that works off to stabilize moods, especially in people with a bipolar disorder type of mood disorders. Option A is mood stabilizers. Option B is antipsychotic medications. Option C is anticonvulsant medications. Option D is antidepressants. The right answer is A. Which of the following is not considered a mood stabilizer? Option A is lithium. Option B is anabolic steroids. Option C is anticonvulsants. Option D is antipsychotic medications. Option E is none of the above. Answer are correct. The right answer is B, anabolic steroids. Next question is a naturally occurring element that was accidentally found to stabilize wounds? Option A is serotonin. Option B is dyskinesia. Option C is lithium. Option D is ability. The right answer is C, lithium. Thank you. Thank you all of you for a wonderful session. Thank you once again.